410-338-1098. You've enjoyed them for years. Josh Spiegel's horrible childhood memories. I appreciate the fact, Josh, that in the past year or so, you've taken to doing them live. You used to go and sit back there in the studio in the laboratory, and you'd write them out the way you've written them out for years, and your writing has won many an award, 5 times, as a matter of fact, soon to be 6. And then in 2020, it seemed like you shifted, and we started having fun with them. You know, your childhood nightmares, but we're having fun, to doing them live on the air. Have you preferred doing the live versions?
You know, I do like doing it live.
We'll do it live!
Yes, I do like doing them live, but I also like them recorded so that we can play them later.
Oh, trust me, those will all be run back, chopped up, maybe a little audio accoutrement, and then experienced all over again. You're going to hear that again this Saturday, by the way. 6 to 10, if you never get a chance to listen, we do a little program called Behind the Curtain, where we play some of the best or worst moments of the show throughout the week, and Josh Spiegel's horrible trip to Israel that wasn't childhood memory is going to be the crown jewel in this weekend's Behind the Curtain. Scott, do you have a horrible childhood memory?
Yeah, I did pee my pants in third grade, Miss Thomas's class. I was rather humiliating.
Not good. Not good.
I mean, what kind of brush are we painting with here? Just a
one that
fun
doesn't
brush?
Involve a stepdad and an index finger.
Because the texters are, I can't even read. I can't read half of these texts.
Yeah,
they're heartbreaking.
We're not going to do those. The ones that are going to ruin our day, we're not going to do. Let's just make that clear real quick.
God.
Okay, just
yeah.
Read the ones that have to do with death.
No, there's some heavy ones that I can't even. I broke my buddy Charlie's pool. It was an above ground pool, and I completely destroyed it. That was an awful day.
That's a bad day.
I pushed off the side. It was an older pool. I pushed off the side, and it created a hole, and then the water started to pour out, and then as the pressure built, the whole side of the pool just split and emptied.
Oh,
that was a really bad day. The one time we were playing in my garage, and we were just goofing off, doing all sorts of stuff, and then we were like sitting in my mom's car pretending we were driving, and then we got into the back seat and there was a neighbor down the street, and he proceeded to like pretend like he was humping me.
Oh.
And he had those like little like 1980s shorts on, like those short shorts,
like the ABA basketball shorts.
Yeah, those super short ones.
Yeah,
and
if you
he
do
had
a
like
lunge, you're gonna see stuff.
Yeah, and as he was like pretending to hump, I could see like his gazenticazoid like flopping.
Oh, no one wants to see that.
And it's like been burned in my mind ever since. Thank God, like it wasn't like a real moment. It was just like a kid's goofing around moment. But I definitely remember the outline of his gazenticazoid flopping in his small 80s shorts, which is, that was an awful memory.
Yeah, what sort of pervert designed those, by the way? Why didn't we just design long, like knee-length shorts for boys and girls and youth in the 90s? What was it about the 60s, 70s, and early
those
to
mid-80s? They were the ones that had like the little white outline around up the side of the legs and then down around like the front of the legs, like those little shorts. And he was like maybe my brother's age, like he was my brother's friend, so he was a little bit older, so it was like he was a little bit more well endowed than the rest of us.
Oh,
it was awful. Just, and I'm pretty sure he was he's a homosexual. I may have been molested. I'm not sure.
Yeah, there's definitely a story about a music teacher and a tickle monster that one day when I find a comfortable enough couch and a quality enough therapist to tell the tale to, I'll tell it to him or her.
Texter says peed my pants, fourth grade recess. Didn't want to use up my recess time to go to the bathroom. Thought I could hold it. And got tackled playing football, and it all let loose. Tried to sneak inside, but the kids saw me walking around. And that was the end of that.
I guess some of the ones that I've shared on the air before. Remember I told you about my mom making a champion shirt?
Yeah.
Yeah,
that was embarrassing when it was obviously not real, and I was immediately just skewered by kids. Oh, another really good
Wasn't
one.
Wasn't that such beautiful intentions, though?
The intentions were great, and kids are such horrible.
I know. Your mom was just trying so hard, and it was so beautiful what she did, and you just got annihilated for wearing a fake champion.
Yeah.
Damn it!
She did a job of it. It was pretty crooked, and there was a lot of threads hanging
right.
out, but still.
Obviously a fake.
It was not good. It was not even remotely close to one, but God, she tried. Another one, I can't remember if I ever told you this on air. This was an awful childhood memory. This was the beginning of anxiety for me. And again, it stems from good intentions. My dad had this big Oldsmobile, and he had ice all over the thing. And it was after like a snow, rain, freezing sleet storm. And I thought I was doing a good job by going out there and cleaning it off. And I found in the front yard, there was this rod that I think was for like a for sale sign from the neighbor's house next door. It is a big, heavy iron stake that went in the ground and you put the sign into it. And it had long since tipped over. It was just lying there. So I picked it up and I slid it under the ice, above the hood, but under the ice, and was popping the ice off his hood. It was like, look at me working smarter, not harder.
Yep.
I am gouging his hood. I did it to his roof. I did it to his trunk. And I remember I wiped it all away with my hands, and I looked, and I saw that I had put at least 9 good gouges on that son of a bitch. So I immediately get more snow, and I pack it back on top of the car. I cover the car again and pray he doesn't notice. And I mean, as we're driving, I'm waiting for him to notice, and he never said anything. And I don't know if he knew it was me or what, but it was bad, bad. And I remember just having sleepless anxiety for nights, waiting for him to kick open my door. Justin! Never did. He might find out about it now if he listened to this program, but he doesn't. He's more of a...
We got a text from Wolf Girl.
Hi, Wolf Girl.
And she got that name because she was in third grade and she started to grow a lot of long hair on her legs. And the boys started to notice, and they all called her Wolf Girl for a year. That's awful!
That sucks!
Oh. Wolf Girl.
God, kids, they're just like baby snakes. They don't know how much venom to give. Let's talk to Heather in Parkville. It might sound small, but it means a lot to her. What's your horrible childhood memory?
Yes, I was in first grade, and my mother was an excellent seamstress. She knew how to make clothes, kind of like, you know, his story with the champion shirt. My mom made a pair of jeans that had apples for back pockets, and all of the kids in school were made, oh, they're stupid, they're making fun of them. But then I grow up, and everybody's got apple-bottom jeans.
So you were just sort of ahead of your time, but at the... At the age you're at, it just looked like someone sewed fruit on your ass.
Yeah, you know, it was and they made fun of me, and I was so embarrassed because I thought they were cool as hell. My mom made me, you know, jeans with shape, you know, these cool
apple
shapes.
Apple butt.
Apple bottom jeans and the boots with the fur.
Got everybody there looking at her. Oh, that yeah, kids are terrible. Let's talk to Joanna in Columbia, who's been patiently holding.
Hello?
Hi,
hello,
what's your
boy.
Horrible childhood memory?
Hello.
Hi.
Hello.
Joanna.
So, in elementary school, I was deeply afraid of getting the stomach virus and throwing up in school. And it's ironic because I'm a nurse now, but I would not go to school. Was afraid to go to school. I was in probably sixth grade, and this was in West Virginia, so elementary school was still sixth grade. And one day I get a knock at the door, and my principal was at my door and literally dragged me into school because I hadn't been going to school. My parents did not know what to do. So my principal had to take me by the hand to my classroom when I was in sixth grade.
Oh, my God. You had an Ed Rooney. Ed Rooney from Ferris Bueller showed up to try and see if he was sick or not. There's been two principals in history. Rooney from Ferris Bueller and yours that showed up at home. God,
right.
That's got to be embarrassing. Let's go to, God, so many women with horrible childhood stories, but I'm glad that you listen. Elizabeth, what's going on, Liz?
Hi. My dad used to do this thing called Weird and Wonderful. So if he felt that our family was getting too picky about what we eat, he would have us eat strange things for dinner. And one of them was like a jello with, it was like a lime jello with broccoli and cottage cheese and pineapple in it.
Like an ambrosia salad?
That's like a mental problem.
Yeah, your father might have been an insane man.
Yeah.
At least dinner wasn't covered in denim.
Trying to get them to eat their vegetables, that's all.
Just wrapped
in jello. But who thinks of that?
Who the hell's like, yeah, what if we put meatloaf in cake to get you to eat it?
I'm Googling broccoli jello.
Oh, God, that seems like something you'd see at like some...
Oh, there it is. It's a real recipe.
Some like church block party or something. The insane old lady with all the brooches. I made my famous broccoli jello mold. The Lord inspired me last night. Try some of my pancake water. It's water.
It's called a sequin salad.
With pancakes in it. A sequin salad? No. Not eating it. Let's talk to Zach in Westminster. See how he's doing. Zach, good morning.
Yeah, boys, so it's not exactly true what you said, that Bobby didn't have any bad childhood memories. I was in Albany one time, and I felt something tickle the bottom of my foot while I was sleeping, and there I was, a grown man with this little boy looking right at me, and he ran out of the room screaming. And lo and behold, my punishment for that, 20 years later, he moves to my city and ruins my sports for 28 minutes a day.
Oh! Jeez, where was Bob's mom in that one? There's always